Welcome back to Online Video Student. Today we're going to take a look at iOS 11. There's a lot of new features in it and a lot of things have changed. One of the things that's changed is how you can take screenshots. Let's say you're looking at a browser and you see a picture you'd like to share with some people, but there's text and other things in the way. Well, it's pretty easy to take a screenshot and most people know how to do it. Hold down the power button either on the side or on the top and then quickly press the home button and that takes a picture. One of the first things you'll notice differently here is that down in the left-hand corner shows you a thumbnail of the picture you just took. If you do nothing, it disappears and it's saved to your photo roll automatically. If you do tap on that thumbnail, it takes you immediately into the editing screen. In here you can crop, and if it's all you want to do, you can save at that point. But if you'd like to make notes on it, point something out to someone, you can tap things like the magic marker. And if you're not happy with what you've done, just simply hit the undo button and it'll take you right back to where you were. You can change the colors. Pick something a little better that might work with a photograph. And then you have other options, such as text signature and magnifier. Let's add a magnifier to this picture. With this, you can actually do a little call out to a specific portion of the picture. You can adjust it for greater or less magnification. But let's say you want to focus in on something specific in the picture, which is probably the best thing for this, such as her bracelet. You can adjust it. Either way, just hit undo and it takes it away if you don't want to have it. Let's add an arrow to this. You can adjust it, you can make it longer, you can make it shorter, you can change the color of the arrow, whatever you'd like to do. Next, let's add some text. It opens up a standard little text window. You can adjust the size and position. You can edit it, tap inside of it, and you can type out whatever you'd like to type out. Initially, it always starts out as black, but we'll change that in a second. Again, position it, stretch out the size of the box. And then as you edit it, you've got choices of changing the font, size, the kerning. You can also change the color. Now, at that point, you've got a number of different options. You can send it, use it as message, save it to files, create even a watch face. Or, if you're done and you want to save it, just simply click the Done button in the upper left-hand corner and save to photos. There you go. You're back to where you originally started from. And in photos, there's your picture with all of your edits. And that's how you take screenshots under iOS 11. Thanks a lot for joining us today. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And of course, please subscribe to our channel. We'll be back soon with more iOS 11 tips and tricks for you.